quick. I'm not going to add anything except the hair to this thing. Oh, I guess I should say what I'm going to do. Just pick anything. Where's the hair? Oh. I'm going to show how to export from the new VRoid Studio. This is 1.9. And import it into Blender, convert it using Bento Buddy, upload it to Second Life. And it's all ready. So I will just click the upload thing, and let's see, that's the upload thing, in order to export to VRM. And it puts it in a T pose, that's convenient. I guess I have to click the export button. Required title, new creator. I can't tab into the next field. Me. And I don't really care about anything else. Export. Remember where you exported this thing. I'm going to paste in a folder here. I already exported dum dum. I think this is GLB. I'm going to change it GLB because that's what Blender will import it as. And it'll take a moment to do its stuff. Remember, it's GLB. And I think we're done there. Let's go over to Blender. This will be imported as GLTF. But you'll notice also that one of the extensions is GLB, which is a GLTF file except in binary format. GLTF original is in text. And that's how we get it into Blender. I will save my work now. That same folder, and then I notice that the item is facing plus, positive Y, so I don't want that. I want it to be facing negative Y, so I can do that here. On the Z, I can give it a... No, I can't do that effectively because it's quaternions. But I could swap that, I guess, and then do it. Yeah, okay. So would that be plus... Nope, we're going 180. Alright, once we've done that, I want to apply the rotation or orientation of that. Apply rotation. Now let's see if this is rotated. I don't think so. What is the hair connected to? Armature 1. Okay. It imported as armature 1 because I imported a previous one. It would have just been armature. It doesn't really matter. We don't need this piece of junk there. And now we're just going to load the VRoid Studio 1.9 Plus conversion map. Okay, now I have to load the VRoid map onto the rig. This is for 1.9. And I want to make sure that I import the pose upon conversion because the fingers aren't right for Second Life, but they will be. And just for testing, I want to make copies. I don't want to convert the existing one. It'll make a copy of it. and you'll see that the copy has its fingers spread out like Second Life expects. And I can just export that right from here. When I'm done, I can just delete it, because it's not good for anything. It's just conversion from the original. Just hit delete, and that's done. You can just do convert for another one afterwards if you want to continue testing. Now I'm going to upload this. Show just how it works. Reduce all those. You see that the fingers are spread. Make sure to include joint positions. This doesn't work otherwise. And you can see it's all goofed up. If you're making your own custom avatar, you don't have to do that. And by that I mean if you're not going to use the existing in-world animations, you can do whatever you like. But this one's using the default animations just for testing. And that's it. Cool beans. If you want to know how to float that name tag higher, make your way into Discord, and we'll show you how to do it from Blender. But you can also adjust that in your viewer, I think.